So there's a common problem a lot of people have when they try to use custom icons in Mac Finder. A few times over the last month somebody has contacted me about exactly the same problem. So I thought I'd explain what the issue is. Say you have a folder like this, Project A folder, and you want to make it stand out. So you want to use a custom icon. You could be using a custom icon for a file or an application or anything. This is the same process. You would select it, use Command I to bring up information about it, and there you've got the icon there in the information window. You can even click and select it there and you can see it gets highlighted. Now you want to replace it, say with this red folder icon graphic. You could have maybe made that in Photoshop or you could have downloaded it, but you have this graphic that you want to use as an icon. So the first thing you may think to do is to drag this file here and drop it. But instead of getting this nice red folder, you get an icon that says PNG in it, the file type for this graphic. It's not what you wanted at all. So you think, well, maybe I need to copy and paste. So I will select this file here, Command C to copy. I'll go back to the info window. I'll go to here, Command V to paste. Same thing. I still get the PNG icon there for the folder, which is not what I want. Maybe if I select the icon file there, I use Command I on it, and I grab that icon, and I can see that that icon is not actually what I see here, but it's actually that same icon there, that PNG. So you actually were, in those cases, applying the icon of the red folder file to the Project A folder. But that icon was actually PNG, not this. This isn't the icon. This is actually a preview that the Finder generates. Since it's an image, it replaces the icon with a preview of the image. So this is frustrating. How do I get this red folder icon there? Well, the important part is to remember that there's a difference between the file and the file's contents. Think of it like getting an old-fashioned letter, right? The letter arrives in an envelope. The entire letter is the envelope and the piece of paper inside. But you want the contents. The contents is just the letter inside. So what we want is just the image, which is the contents inside the file. So I'm going to double click it and it will launch preview and open up the image. And I can see this graphic here. Now I'm going to select all and I can see a border goes around the entire image and I'm going to copy. I'm copying the contents of the file as opposed to the file itself. So now when I go to my Project A folder there, use Command I, click on the icon and Command V to paste, it's going to paste the contents of the red folder icon into it, which gives me the replaced icon there. I'm actually placing the contents, the graphics, into the icon rather than the file itself into it. So that's how you do it. That's the problem a lot of people run into, is just trying to use the file to replace the icon rather than the contents of the file. It's pretty easy to do. You can just use preview to get those contents out by copying them in preview and using them as an icon there.